Hi students, intermediate second year English medium. We are discussing the first unit. So in the first unit, so many topics were discussed by the previous videos, and today I am going to analyze the determinants of economic development. What are the determinants of economic development? Which factors can supporting the economic development, and which factors can discourage the economic development, means hindering of economic development, are the discussing topic in this video. Let me analyze it one by one here. Determinants of economic development. So here, determinants of economic development is divided into two categories. One is economic factors and non-economic factors. What is the economic factors? Economic means financial. So we have to purchase, it is a cost. Double petti konte than economic factor, is it? So here economic, it is a financial factor. We have to purchase that goods and services, that factors. So the factors which we have to purchase, that is called economic factor. One. Second one is non-economic factor. No need to purchase. It is available in the nature. It is available in the society. Such are called non-economic factors. No need to purchase these factors. So this how to purchase the factors. Which are, which we have to purchase, and which are the supporting to the economic development. Let me say a few words about the economic development. The real output of goods and services along with institutional, technical, social changes is called economic development. Already I told number of times, economic development is a dimensional process. So we have to change the all attitudes, all precautions, all institutional changes. So economic development. So we are in the economic development. But what are the factors? What are the factors we have to support to the economic development? Which means here, determinants of economic development, let me analyze it here. Economic factors are capital formation. The economic development is depend upon the capital formation. If the capital formation is very high, automatically it is possible to reach the economic development. If the capital formation is very low, we are not reached the economic development. So the economic development is totally depends upon the capital formation. What is the capital formation? Means here, suppose income of the people, say income of the people, income out of income, the most of the people are, they will be saving. Then saving is leads to the capital. Capital leads to the investment. See, how we formulate the capital? The capital is nothing but the saving. The saving amount is the lump sum is called capital. So here, when the capital is very huge, it is possible to establishment of expansion of the economy. We can improve the industrial sector. It is possible to improve the agriculture sector. It is possible to improve the service sector. Is it? So it is a need for the investment. But capital formation is very low. The countries which per capita, which capital formation is very low, such are called developing countries. The countries which having the capital formation is very high, such are called developed countries. You know, when we compare to the developed countries, in those countries their per capita, their income is very high. When the income increases, the saving will be also increases. When the saving increases, capital also increases. Formation means changes. Means here, we want to increase the capital formation. How can we increase the capital formation? By improving the income of the consumer, income of the people. So when we provide more and more income facilities, more and more employment facilities, this is a source to increase the income level. When the income level increases, saving increases, capital increases, and the investment will be also increases. When the investment is supporting to the economic development. Okay, so this is a economic factor. First one is a capital formation. If the availability is capital formation is very high, automatically it is support to the economic development. If not, it is a low development. Then natural resources, yes, the availability of natural resources is also one of the causes due to arise the economic development. You know, water, sunlight, air, minerals, and natural resources which are gifted by the nature. When this availability is very high, automatically it is possible to reach the economic development. Is it? So that's why the natural resources is also one of the determinant factors of economic development. Suppose you know the Gulf countries, Iran, Iraq, Kuwait, in those countries they have plenty of oil products in their land. Why? It is a natural resource. No one can produce. No one can produce. So, the availability of natural resources. Suppose the availability of natural resources, minerals are there. If we have in the plenty of mineral resources, that is useful to our economic development. So, as a result, here what I want to say here, the availability of natural resources increases. It is a possibility of economic development. If not, the development will be low. Means this is also one of the determinant factors of economic development. This is natural resources. Then agrarian structure. Yes, the most of the developing countries, they have in the agrarian structure. It is the backbone of Indian economy, and the developing countries have backbone of agricultural structure. So the structure of agriculture is changed to the industrial and the service sector. The importance of agriculture is changed to the industrial service sector, then the automatically the per capita, the national income, the GDP will be also increases. So agrarian structure to be need to change to the industrial and the service sector, then there is a possible to economic development. Then marketable surplus. Exactly. What is the marketable surplus? Means suppose if a farmer is getting 100 quintals of goods or paddy, for example, he getting the 100 quintals of paddy. Out of 100 quintals, he is stored 60 quintals for his consumption. He stored the 60 quintals for his consumption. The remaining only 40 quintals is ready to market. What is the market they want to sell? How many quintals they want to market? 40 quintals. The 40 quintals are called marketable surplus. How many quintals they produced? 100. What is the consumption quintals is preserved? 60 quintals. How many quintals they want to sell? 40 quintals. The 40 quintals are marketable, is ready to sell surplus. So here, when we want to achieve the economic development, there is a increase the marketable surplus. How? So the 40 quintals is increased to 100 quintals. When the 100 quintals increases automatically, it is possible to economic development. But how can we increase? Means the people who are depends on agriculture, their total productivity should be increases. Then the total production increases, the marketable surplus, the sales which they want to market, that should be increases. When the marketable surplus increases, it is possible to economic development. So this is also one of the cause. It is a marketable surplus. Then industrial structure. Yes, the industrial structure is very important. So when we, it is a strong industrial structure, it is possible to provide more and more employment opportunities. Isn't it? So we have to improve the number of industries. We have to establish number of industries. The government should provide more and more industries. Okay. And most of the incentives, most of the industries are, it is possible to establishment in village areas. Then only we can provide the more and more employment opportunities. So it is a need to the industrial structure of the economy. You know, the developed countries, their developed countries totally, it is a based on the industrial development. The developed countries are totally based on the industrial development. But there is a strong build-up of the industrial sector. So this is also one of the need, industrial structure. If the industrial structure is very strong, it is possible to economic development. If not, the economic development is very low. Okay, so industrial structure. Then structural changes. So what are the structural changes? Agriculture to be need. Industrial sector to be need, and the service sector to be need. The people who are depends on agriculture sector is migrate to the industrial and service sector. and their attitude to be changed. So then these are the structural changes in the of a country. So when the structural changes increases, automatically it's possible to economic development. If not, there is a low level of economic development. So these are the determinants of economic development. Next, organizations, yes, entrepreneurs. If the country having the more and more organizations, that is a possible to establishment of number of industries. Suppose the more industries, more organizers are there, they are ready to establishment of number of industries. When we establish a number of industries, it is possible to provide the more and more employment opportunities. So when provide more and more employment opportunities, it is possible to get the more per capita income and existence level of the people, and they can maintain a better quality of life. So these are all the positive things, which is organization. The people who are ready to establishment of number of industries, establishment of agriculture expansion, establishment of service sector. This is a organization needs to be increased. పెట్టుబడి పెట్టే వాళ్ళు ఎక్కువ ఉండాలి. ఎంత పెట్టుబడి పెట్టే వాళ్ళు ఎక్కువ ఉంటే అంత ఎకానమీ డెవలప్మెంట్ అవుతుంది, లేకుంటే వెనక పడిపోవచ్చు. ఓకే, దెన్ టెక్నికల్ ప్రోగ్రెస్. ఎస్, వెన్ వీ వాంట్ టు ఇంప్రూవ్ ద ప్రొడక్షన్, వీ హ్యావ్ టు అడాప్ట్ ద టెక్నికల్ ప్రోగ్రెస్. వితౌట్ టెక్నికల్ ప్రోగ్రెస్ వీ కాంట్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ ద మోర్ ప్రొడక్టివిటీ. If you want to produce the more and more in agriculture, industrial, service sector, we have to introduce the technical progress. Is it? So when we provide the more and more technical progress, it is possible to economic development. How economic development? The production increases. When the production increases, it is possible to increase the economic development. So this is also one of the supporting factor. Then division of labor. Yes, division of labor, skilled labor and talent labor and efficient labor. When the people are having the sufficient skill and skill labor, automatically the production will be also increases. So when the production increases, automatically it is possible to increase the economic development. Maybe it is a division of labor to be need, skill labor, talent labor and technological knowledge labor to be need to increase the economic development. So how can prepare the skilled labor? By providing more and more education facilities, by providing more and more healthy facilities. So when we provide more and more healthy facilities, there is a working hours will be also increases. When we provide education facilities, there are people who are going to participate in economic activities, so their talent will be increases, their knowledge will be increases, they will be make as a skilled labor. So it is also one of the technical program, division of labor. This also need to improve the economic development. So without skills, without talent, we can't produce the more productivity in various sectors. Then foreign trade. So when we increase the agriculture development, then we increase the industrial development, then we increase the service sector development. So when we provide more and more, when we increase the more and more productivity, it is possible to export the foreign countries. By getting more income, exporting the goods and services. So when we getting the more foreign exchange, it is possible to economic development. So this is also one of the supporting factor. Then economic system. Yes, what are the policies are there? What are the system is there? What are the changes are there? Are also one of the factors of economic development. So these are the determinants of economic development. One is economic factors one hand, and the other hand is non-economic factors. It is a non-commercial. These are the commercial, non-commercial. One is human resources. What is the human resources? The total population of the country, out of 130 crores of population, but the workforce is only the 50 to 55%. How? Why? Because there is no talent, there is no skills. The remaining people are totally illiteracy. They have no get the more productivity by implementing the modern technology. So human resources are there, but what I want to hear, human, what is the human resources? The skilled labor are called human resources. Out of 130 crores of population, try to understand, 130 crores of population, only 55% of the workforce is there. The remaining peoples are there, depends on 50%. వీళ్ళు మాత్రమే పనిచేస్తారు, మిగిలిన వాళ్ళు వీళ్ళ మీద ఆధారపడి బతుకుతారు. మరి హ్యూమన్ రిసోర్సెస్ ఉంది, 130 క్రోర్స్ ఆఫ్ హ్యూమన్ రిసోర్సెస్ ఉంది, మరి ఎక్కడ వాడుతున్నారు? అవునా. అందుకని ఏం చేయాలి, వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఇంప్రూవ్ ద హ్యూమన్ రిసోర్సెస్. సో హౌ కెన్ వీ ఇంప్రూవ్ ద హ్యూమన్ రిసోర్సెస్? బై అడాప్టింగ్ ద ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఫెసిలిటీస్, బై అడాప్టింగ్ ద హెల్త్ ఫెసిలిటీస్. వెన్ వీ ప్రొవైడ్ మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ హెల్త్ ఫెసిలిటీస్, దేర్ లైఫ్ ఎక్స్పెక్టెన్సీ విల్ బి మోర్. దే కెన్ వర్క్ వెరీ, దే కెన్ వర్క్ ఎక్స్ట్రా అవర్స్ వెన్ హీ విల్ హెల్దీ. వెన్ దే ఎడ్యుకేట్ ద పీపుల్ ఆటోమేటిక్లీ దే కెన్ గెట్ ద మోర్ ప్రొడక్టివిటీ. So there should be need to the human resources, means so the working population should be increases. The worker population, only the 50 to 55% you know, the developed countries, in those countries 90% of the people are, they are participating in economic activities. Okay, here male and female, the most of the males are participating in economic activities. But in India, in developed countries, most of the females are, they are not interested to participate in the economic activities. Why? Because so many traditions are there. So many old beliefs are there. So they are not interested in economic activities. But you see the developed countries, male and female, there is no discrimination in between them. It is difficult to identify who is male and who is female in developed countries. Why? Because their appearance, their workforce, their participation, everything will be same. But in these countries, easily we can identify as male and female. Why? Because there is a discrimination between male and female. Due to the most of the females are not participating in economic activities. Without participating in the economic activities, how can we get the more workforce? Okay, just now it is the more that they're talented, their psychology, their approaches will be changes. Then the 5 to 10% of females are there going to and participate to economic activities. But the changes to be made, the male and female both are equal, they are going to participate in economic activities, then only we can get the more per capita income. More per capita income leads to the more GDP. More GDP leads to the more economic development. So, human resources, skilled labor to be need, human resources to be need, workforce to be need. Then, political administrations, yes. What are the policies of the government? What are the administrative factors are there? What are the policies are there? What are the precautions are taken by the government to reduce the poverty, to reduce the unemployment, and how the government is providing more and more employment opportunities? So the political administrative, what are the benefits are provided by the government? How the people are getting the more income? So these are all factors can lead to the economic, non-economic factors. Okay. Next to social factors, yes, attitude of the people, psychology of the people, approaches of the people. So the most of the people are illiteracy. They are living in the rural areas. They are following the old beliefs, traditional methods. So they are not introduced the technology in the process of the production. They are following the old beliefs. How can they get more productivity? So social factors are also one of the determinant factors. You know, developed countries, they have no follow the old beliefs. That they are introduced the technology in the process of the production. They have to implement the modern technology in the process of the production. But in these countries, most of the peoples are, they are following the traditions. They are illiteracy persons. Okay, so these are the social factors. So these are the factors, the determinants of economic development. So this is the way of the presentation of determinants of economic development. So students, this is the information of determinants of economic development. Thank you.